And good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to wherever it is we are. Where is it we are?
Russell Middle School Baseball.
Russell Middle School. Donnie Prater.
Hello, everybody.
Joe Applegate to my right. And this is Hank Bond, and I'm really glad to be with you here today as we are going to bring you the play-by-play, I hope, at least. I'm getting a lot of echo, but we'll just do what we do. And we're going to have Russell and Greenup County Middle School Baseball. And we have the lineups ready here. And I just talked to Donnie Watkins and Brad Stoltz as we're just about ready to get underway. And I think if we do this right, Donnie.
Absolutely.
Donnie will be Mr. Color. Coming up will be Austin Evans. He'll lead off for the Greenup County Junior Musketeers. He plays center field for Brad Stoltz. Here we go. Donnie's going to be in trouble before the day's over.
Absolutely. I live in trouble.
I can see that.
Mm-hmm. Fairly used to it.
I know. You're married to Marcy. That right along there will get you in trouble. Don't you think? I think it will.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Just call me Doghouse.
I'll call you something. Okay. Here we go. On the mound is Isaac Jenkins for the Junior Devils. And here's the first pitch. Swing and a miss, strike one. That's a good start. Underway.
Nice. Isaac gets a lot of movement on his ball. You can see it by that pitch, definitely.
Lifted in the air. And pulled in by the second baseman for Russell. And that out there at second today is Ethan Sharp. So F4 if he's scoring. One out. And it'll be Eli Sammons. First pitch, right back to Jenkins. On to first, Evan Tice. And that's 1-3, two outs. And we'll bring to the plate now Drew Stoltz. I'm sure Drew is.
For the Musketeers, Drew Stoltz.
He is the son of Bradley, I suppose. Is that Brad's son?
Yes, it is.
That's why I have you here, Donnie.
He looks just like him.
We have stories about Donnie, but we'll hold those up for later. The pitch.
Yes.
Donnie just lives for his job. He gets the opportunity to go to spend a week in Middlesbrough, and that right there was just almost more than a career man can ask for. Inside ball two.
It doesn't get much better than Middlesbrough.
This is Knoxville.
Down in the crater. Well, yeah, Knoxville's a nice town as well.
Here's a grounder to third. One hop on to first.
And he's out.
Tice hauls it in. And that's three outs. So Stoltz is out third to first, which is Curtis Davis, Evan Tice. And Evan Tice, my grandson, I do not pretend not to celebrate that. And we'll be back with the bottom of the first. Coming up, Austin Watkins, Cameron Campbell, better known as Peanut, and Evan Tice right here on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
We'll be right back.
Austin Watkins.
Austin Watkins steps into the plate. He's a shortstop for the Red Devils. I just love doing junior high ball because this is all about the game, Donnie. That's what it's all about.
Absolutely.
Purity of the game. He drills this one into left center. And it'll be picked up out there by the left fielder, who is Austin Clarkson. And so Russell starts off with a single. Next up is Cameron Campbell. As I said, better known as Peanut. Joe Campbell tried to keep up with the ball through these backstop wires. It's kind of tough. Swing and a miss comes right back at us. You know, Donnie, I know you'd have caught that if that had came in here.
Absolutely. I was trying to lay out for it, but
right.
I just wasn't quick enough.
Just couldn't stretch far enough.
My cat-like reflexes aren't what they used to be. Uh-oh.
We don't have any fun here. If I couldn't do this and have fun, I wouldn't want to do it.
Absolutely.
So here's the 0-1 pitch.
Runner.
Strike two. On the way goes down Watkins. He's in there safe with a stolen base. Had to put the hit and run on there as fast as Austin is.
Absolutely.
But I'm only the announcer. Donnie gets the big bucks. On the mound is Eli Salmon. Here's one right to short. That's going to move Watkins. Or let's see, is he out? Got him. Said he came down on it. So Campbell out 6-3. Watkins moves on to third on the play. And here's Austin, Evan Tice, with Austin on third and a chance to play to run. I'll feed him just like you feed Will. If he knocks one in, we'll buy him supper.
Yeah, he doesn't
swing and a miss.
He'll get a hit. I let him come in the house. He doesn't just sleep
on the porch. I understand
that. Here we go.
He's got a new toy now. He's got that thing that protects his elbow, too.
I like it.
And here's the 0-1.
Right
at the middle for a base hit in the center field. On the score is Watkins, and Russell takes a 1-0 lead here in the bottom of the first inning. Okay, so he gets supper now, Donnie. That's kind of papaw I am, just so you know. And this would be Isaac Jenkins.
Having trouble with the.
You have to reset it. Left center field on the first pitch hit.
Nice
on the second. Isaac on first.
Who's up now, Ronan?
Coming up now will be Ronan Moore. So Russell with one out in the inning, a run in, two runners on. And we have somebody at the door, but they'll just have to hang on a second. They're going to get the bat, so we have time. That's okay, because the most important guy in the ballpark is here for Donnie. Ryland had to have a little cash for the concession stand. This one on to second. They could get a double. Nope, dropped it. That'll be an error on the shortstop. Tice moves on to third. The bases are loaded as Moore reaches on a fielder's choice. Jenkins on the error six. And we're ready to go now with Josh Griffith. And, you know, Fairview proved this boy can hit the ball now. There's no doubt about it.
Oh, absolutely.
Josh had a couple really hard hits. Call strike one. You know, doing play-by-play, Donnie, makes it hard to eat nachos.
Yeah.
Bases loaded. Pitch. Foul away. No balls, two strikes. Griffith kind of rushed on that a little bit.
Just a bit. I think he was trying to protect the man. Right. The man had a big lead.
So no balls, two strikes on Griffith. Salmons looks in, pitches. This one grounded foul out of first baseline. Down on one knee to scoop it up. Joe Campbell.
He anchors that first base very well.
Yeah, he doesn't have his gloves on today.
Doesn't
he? He said that one day he liked to froze to death out there.
He has maybe 2% body fat. It's caught high
outside side of ball. That makes it a ball and two strikes. 1-0, even though Donnie cannot work the scoreboard.
Still trying to figure out why we're guests.
Outside ball. My son just messaged me to tell me I should not be eating nachos.
Tell him you have a column to write.
That's it. Deep to center field. That's the out. Tice tags up. He comes down. He'll
and
be safe
scores.
At the plate.
All right.
Okay. So Jenkins goes on to third. Tice scores. Josh Griffith out sacrifice fly to eight. So that won't count against him on his batting average. That's two outs. And this is Curtis Davis, the third baseman. Call strike one, and on down to second is Moore. That is a non-contested stolen base.
I thought there was two outs, but
got
nope. A little extra.
The first out was Peanut. First, short to first. Then we had that error out there.
Right.
And they did not get the front end of the double play.
That's right. The error got me all screwed up.
Here's the pitch, outside of ball. My daughter, Amy, in Las Vegas is watching the game live today on greenupbeacon.com.
Awesome.
And my son, Michael, pitch, high outside, is watching the game. And thank you, Michael. Michael sends me these happy notes. Says a column doesn't affect your blood sugar.
Oh.
There's a pitch fouled away. So I'm in trouble, Donnie. I won't tell him about the M&Ms that Sadie tried to give me.
And that Snickers bar sitting on your scorebook over there. Here, I'll talk while you chew. How about
now, former, that? former announcer, Donnie Prager.
Leave it up there.
Full count. Two on, two out, two runs in. Pitch, swung on, lifted high. Shortstop goes, that's going to drop.
It is going to drop.
It'll be
that's
a base hit, and Russell will get two runs out of it. So Davis gets a single and a couple RBIs to make it 4-0 Russell.
Is that Robert?
Now batting for the Devils, Robert Johnson.
Robert Johnson, he's a designated hitter today. Nate Conley is playing out there, and where's Conley playing? Let's see here. That's the wrong sheet.
He's usually
on our sheet. No.
There it is.
There it is.
I believe.
Johnson, swing and a miss. Nate Conley is out in that field. I put he and Ethan both at second. That didn't work.
Oh,
this one,
there's a nice, oh.
Well, he had him. Good throw.
Okay.
And so, Davis is stranded. Johnson out 4-3 for the third out. As we move to the top of the second, it's Russell 4 and Greenup County nothing.
Our emphasis has always been on first name friendly service with a hometown touch. We know you and you know us. Hometown people helping each other grow. We're here to serve all your banking needs. First and People's Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC. We are the home office.
Hometown people, hometown spirit.
Heavenly Father, thank you for today. Thank you for the opportunities it holds for growth, learning, and enjoyment. And for the time to share with others. I pray for peace and joy in mind, body and spirit, and for the hope of this day. In your name, amen.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
Mm-hmm. thanks everybody for joining us here at greenupbeacon.com. Brian Groves becomes the new Russell High School boys basketball coach, and that'll be announcement will be in the big paper tomorrow, but we have it today, so you can count on Greenup Beacon and greenupbeacon.com and greenupbeaconradio.com and greenupbeacon.com news site and anything else to be first. Thank you so much. And Dale, you pinned it, but I had it first. Groves is a 2003 Russell graduate. I'm going to tell you the truth. I'll tell you something in a minute, Donnie.
Gotcha.
Pitch. Ooh. Inside. This is Mr. Keaton, Griffin Keaton.
I'm not going to pick on him much more.
No.
I thought about playing
No, because
music.
It is a pretty far drop out the window. Swing, foul down the first baseline. Tice comes over to the bag, but it's way too far. But I think that it's possible I go to church with this young man.
Oh, okay. Where do you go to church at?
Advance Memorial.
Advance Memorial.
There's one lifted into left field. Takes a one hopper.
Right in.
Runs up into Conley's lap. So now Greenup County has a hit on its first bat here in the, or first batter here in the top of the second.
Greenup Musketeers in their green, yellow, black stripe.
Yeah,
sharp
you know,
uniforms.
That shows up on the camera well over to first.
Very sharp uniforms.
All right, here you go. He was a student assistant at the University of Alabama women's team, 210 to 211. We'll be back to him in a minute. A pitch. High.
A little high.
Assistant coach at Russell High School in 2014, and then an assistant coach at Eastern High School, which is in Louisville, from 2014 to 16. So it is a new coach. New man, a new coach.
New change. And next devil at that.
Right.
Always good.
Outside of ball.
Three-o here. And he walked in.
Ball four. Thanks. That's Ashton Lacey. Next up, Richie Green. So two on, nobody out. We're in the top of the second inning. Russell up 4-0.
Excuse me.
No problem. Swing and a miss, strike one. I don't think this is the same fellow. But I do know this much, that he...
This is down the third base line. Conley's over to get it. He sends it in to Davis. Davis catches it, stops the runner.
They plate Keaton. And so I don't know if that's Eric Keaton's son or not. Could very well be. And so we have Lacey Ware at second. And we have a single from Richie Green. So it's 4-1. And Cotton Holman will come to the plate. My son so astutely pointed out, Donnie, a fact that I failed to remember. You are never an ex-devil. You're always a devil, once a devil.
Devil for life.
Pitch. Strike. Nope. Ball. Outside. See, Donnie, if we get cheated, you can just bring some hazmat material.
Can absolutely do that.
I'm sure Mr. Pennington would go over that, right?
He would. He sure would. Hey, we got a strike out of that one.
Did he call a strike?
He sure did.
This 35 minutes between when the pitch is thrown and the pitch is called.
Yeah, that's... I don't like that new method of umpiring that they're
this
teaching.
This swung on down the right field side.
Hey, he didn't tag it.
One out.
There's two outs.
Two outs. They get him?
Yeah,
heck yeah! Okay, so that's two outs. So that would be F9, and that in right field is Mr. Moore. He fired it to Evan Tice to pick off, so that'd be 9-3 for the second out. He may get dessert.
Absolutely.
Tonight. We'll have to talk to Jim and see if Ronan's going to get treated well. 4-1, our score. Here's a pitch. Outside, gets away from Ratliff, or Campbell. And so we're going to call that one a pass ball. And that sends Lacey on to third. Two outs. And Austin Clarkson is at the plate. He's a lefty. And I'm surprised to see that he didn't lead him off when he had him on there to lead off. Often you want that left-handed hitter trying to break the ice early.
Absolutely.
Here's a pitch high. Down at third is Ashton Lacey. Also, Amy said, thanks, Donnie. Amy said that she loves Snicker bars.
Well, we've got 4 or 5 up here if she'd like to come on over.
Sure. She's in Las Vegas. She'll be here in time.
Yeah. It's the next plane out.
Yeah, they'll be here in July, so I get to see my three Nevada grandbabies.
Come here so they can enjoy the cool weather in July.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's a different kind of hot.
Yes, it is.
Out there, it's really hot. But the lack of humidity does help some.
It sure pitch. Does.
Foul away. Come on in, Marcy.
Okay.
Where are you leaving?
I gotta go to play at school, but I'll be back.
I've heard that about you.
I'll be back, yeah.
Be careful. Marcy Prater. Donnie and Marcy are the mother of and father of Will, who plays on the B team and sometimes on the varsity. This one is second. Sharp picks it up, fires it on, safe. Got him. Thought he'd beaten it. I thought he was there by a step, but not. And that's the third out of the inning. So as we move to the bottom of the second inning, it's Russell 4 and Greenup County nothing. Coming up, Ethan Sharp, Austin Watkins, and Campbell. Right here on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
When I first come in, I go get on a rolling chair. It has little rollers and you lay down and it pushes, like, does them in your sore spots, upper and lower back. And when I get my, and there's sticky things that they put on your back. And they feel so good because you feel a little tingle and it feels good. And after your first time, it's your best friend. And with the thing I love about being at Dr. Whitaker's office when he pops me and cracks me is when after he pops me in my sore spots and it feels great. The reason why I love...
Visit the Sungate Alpaca Company to experience the vibrant cultural heritage of South America and discover the extraordinary luxury fabric called alpaca. Wrap yourself in a stylish alpaca scarf. Transform your living room by adding texture and color with a hand-loomed alpaca throw blanket, and add a little extra warmth and cozy fashion with an alpaca hat and matching gloves. Visit sungatealpaca.com for all your alpaca needs. Find us on Facebook for special deals and inventory updates. Shop Sungate Alpaca.
I just want to point out that Evan said he really liked his music thing.
Good. Good, good.
Donnie Prater does walk-up music. 4-1. Russell leads it. Number 9 hitter, Ethan Sharp.
I had a lot of fun putting the walk-up music together. I have to say, most of them have liked it, but one in particular, whenever Peanut Campbell came to me, and he said, I'd like my walk-up music to be Marvin Gaye. Let's get it on. And I said, okay, is your mom okay with that? So we had to get a mother's approval before we could play it.
I'm not messing with Michelle either.
No.
Just to be plain.
Absolutely not.
4-1, Evan. Michael. Sadie said she'd be here. I'll get it right. Amy, I call her Amy all the time. Amy will be here in 76 days.
76 days.
Swing, right at the plate, foul. Joe, I don't know if you can pull in any tighter on home plate, maybe. There you go, and then tilt it down just a little bit. Yeah. I know it's... Yeah, that's pretty good. You'll just have to turn it to get the ball if it gets out of the window there. Here's the pitch. Swung on right back to the pitcher, Sammons. He throws it on to the first baseman over there, Holman. And so Sharp starts the bottom of the second. Out pitcher to first, 1-3 if you're scoring. And that's the first out. Second out, or second batter coming up, Austin Watkins with one out. Is that River Dance? Can you do that?
No, that's actually the Dropkick Murphys.
If you do the River Dance thing, we'll turn the camera around.
I can sure give it a try. I'm not stretched out
that's
yet.
That's it. Pitch.
Oh.
Takes the bunt outside. A nice idea. That's not Watkins, though. That's Conley.
Yeah, that's Nathan Conley.
Okay, so how am I doing this? I got 10 players. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
They have an EH. I believe Johnson's EHing.
DHing, yeah. So I take a bat, swing and a miss. This is Nathan Conley. Wonder who Johnson is DHing for.
I'm not sure because we got Watkins on deck, right? So Sharp's Conley's the last batter.
Yeah, right center, left, second, third, shortstop, first. I don't know. We'll just have 10 and we'll figure it out sometime.
Well, yeah.
Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss by Conley. I think that's Nick's brother.
Now batting for the Devils, Austin Watkins.
Now we have Austin Watkins. 1, 2. Catcher, first, second, third, short, left, center. Right. We're just batting a designated hitter because we want to.
I believe so.
Because you're not batting for anybody.
They're running. We have a 9 in the lineup? Or?
Have 10.
10 in the lineup, okay.
Left-hander Sammons brings it to the plate outside of ball. This is Watkins. He's the leadoff hitter. He singled, stole second, and scored on a single by Tice. Moved on to third when Campbell grounded out short to first. Swing outside, or ball outside. You got me confused, Tony.
I'm easy to do.
Yeah.
I confuse myself.
Well.
It's a wonder I'm here tonight.
Yeah, particularly since you read the Beacon on Monday. That, you know, your lips got tired and all.
Yeah, absolutely.
Ball four.
Who's up now? Peanut?
I wish you all could see him up here dancing. Here's Cameron Peanut Campbell.
Peanut Campbell!
Little Marvin Gaye for you here. First 13 years in radio. Let's get it on. I used to have that as my phone ring. Marilyn called me for lunch. I think I took a little ribbon over that. So Sammons looks in with a runner at first and two outs. Glances at first, comes to the plate outside of ball,
out.
Quickly on the way down, and
who's
Austin
in?
Is in again with his second stolen base.
Oh, groovy, baby.
So it's been a good afternoon here. I'm over on my data plan. Outside of ball. That's okay because Donnie's going to reimburse me. That'd be Donnie Prater.
Yeah.
They make big money.
We're going to pass the hat, I've decided, at halftime.
Is that what you're going to do?
We're going to do
that. At halftime we're going to have
all
this game?
We're going to have a fundraiser. We're going to have all the dads come out. And mm-hmm. We're all going to do the whip and the nay-nay and try to raise some money for the Beacon.
Ball. Oh, stolen base.
Second.
So we got him on. We got him down there at third now. Somebody told me the other day, it was Rick Brewer, I think, that he'll pay. He doesn't care. He thinks that this is a pretty good service. So,
I think it's
but that
excellent.
Was before you were on, Tony. Outside
well,
of ball.
I'm sure I can ruin that.
So, Grandson Evan Tice comes to the plate with runners at first and third. Donnie Watkins is going to come down and talk to him. Brad Stoltz out to the mound to talk to his pitcher, Eli Sammons.
It's just it's one of those, don't let them get in your head. You're all right. These are the words that were just said. Don't let them get in your head. It's all right. Nobody's hurt here. Hang in there.
And we're going to stop at Crisps on the way home.
Absolutely. We're going
to
hit the
ice cream. That's what they used to do when Evan played in Fleming County. They'd go out and say, are we going to McDonald's or Dairy Queen? Just to try to break the struggle. Runners at first and third. Here's a pitch from Sammons on the way to second. High inside a ball.
Love these two-out rallies.
Uncontested stolen base. You'll get to count those, you know.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Here's the pitch. Evan got way out in front of that one. Foul tip. I hear his grandmother down there helping him understand that he was ahead of that pitch. I'll be quiet up here.
Positive motivation.
That's it. Ball and a strike. Second and third. Here's the pitch. He swings on this one, drains it into right field. Picked up out there. They're going to send Campbell onto the plate. Here's the throw to the plate. It gets away, and Tice will go on to second base. And with two RBIs on that play, a single in advance on the throw. Heck, I'm going to get prime rib, Donnie. So Evan Tice with a key single with two outs, knocks in two runs. And that'll make it now 6-1. I wish y'all could see Donnie up here busting the move now. I mean, it's almost worthwhile. Yeah, next time Joe says he'll just
I'm out of breath. Back,
pull the camera back and turn it around, buddy.
Man, I told my son, I said, I'll dance every time we play music, and it's starting to come back to haunt me now.
Yeah,
sweating a little bit. Humid tonight.
Isaac Jenkins at the plate, and they throw.
He's in there.
A stolen base for Evan Tice. Did you get that, Joe?
No, I was watching right here.
A little bit behind, okay.
Yeah.
Well,
hang on to the end of the slide.
I got you. So, with a runner on third, Russell up 6-1. Jenkins with a chance to make it 7-1. That one's outside.
We've got several members of the middle school softball team in attendance tonight.
And I think that should always be reciprocated.
Absolutely.
I know one night Evan was riding home with Phil Bartram, and they all stopped at the girls' game up there. I think
absolutely.
When I went to school, that's the way it was.
That's how you should.
Of course, we didn't have girls as a varsity sport then.
Right.
Came a couple years later. And it's 3-0.
They're watching the game too.
Here's the pitch. Strike. Had to take that one, didn't he?
And I have to say, they're watching the game. They're not taking selfies. They're actually watching the game, and this is great. Great to see.
Well, you know, you can, and they're probably having some concessions too.
Oh, absolutely. It's the best part.
It is. Ball four. So Isaac Jenkins, he trots on down to first. Tice at third. And here comes Ronan Moore, who knocked in a reached on a fielder's choice, but allowed Jenkins to be safe on an error. And but anyway, he scored in the first inning. So it's 6-1. Runners on first and third, Jenkins at first, Tice at third, and the pitch on the way. They're going to throw it down.
Throw
here comes Tice.
It
goes into center field.
Yeah.
So that'll
score.
Be an error on the catcher. Allowed that run. So we'll give it to E2. But nonetheless, there's that run, Donnie. And that's
the one we were looking for, wasn't it?
You got it. So Jenkins at second now. And Moore with a solid hit.
No, absolutely. It's Ronan's still batting. It was a, it's going to catch you before you scored it.
Do what now?
Oh, they're pitching out again.
Safe. That's
again.
A true stolen base. Excellent. For Isaac Jenkins. Did you move the camera and catch him? You got to catch those stolen bases, Dad. You got to watch the runner. The camera's set on home plate, so you won't have any problem if they start moving. This is Joe's second game. He'll get it. Swing into right center field. Got a drop.
Right.
Here comes Jenkins to the plate, and a single for Ronan Moore. And he knocks in Jenkins, and that makes it now 8-0. Josh Griffith comes to the plate. It's a conference game and all, right? This is a big deal.
Absolutely. This is the district matchup that we've been waiting on.
And we, of course, missed one that got rained out down there.
That's right. Then we went to play Raceland, and they didn't play us that night.
No one's ever understood that.
No, didn't make – they were there.
On the way to second, plenty of time. And a stolen base for Ronan Moore.
Yeah, Raceland was there. They were dressed. Looked like they were ready to play, but I don't know. Something must have happened that we don't understand.
For those listening, you'll be glad to know that the nachos are gone now. Well, they will be. Except that Donnie will lick the bowl, but swing and a miss. Stolen base.
Stolen base. He's in there again.
Did you get him?
That was smart. Swing
there
that
you go.
Bat. Keep that catcher back and make him throw around you. Smart play on Josh's behalf.
Griffith stands in there. That's a ball. We got 2-1, Donnie.
I believe it is 2-1.
I think so. We don't get much help from home plate.
No, we never do.
He's got a lot to watch. He's got to watch that runner down there.
Absolutely.
Pitch out.
We do have one of my favorite umpires of all time. Mike Brown is out there. He's anchoring the field duties tonight. Great guy. I go to church with him and just a fine fella.
Did you say he's Russell boy?
He is. Sure is. Both of his kids went through the Russell system as well.
Both your kids are going to graduate from Russell.
Absolutely.
Outside, ball 4. That'll send Mr. Griffith, who sacrificed a run in.
Now
in the first.
Curtis Davis.
Curtis Davis will come up, and he's looking for a chance. He singled in the last inning, but was stranded at first. Russell with a nice lead here.
I think they're going to steal.
On the way. Surely not.
Oh, well, look at this.
Dribbled it. Here he comes at the plate. He's safe. And again, Donnie, that would be an error on the catcher.
Absolutely.
So, another run in. That makes it 5 in the inning. So, it is now a 9-1 game. Everybody settles in out there. Truth is, Donnie, they're not helping Salmons much.
No. They're
down to third. He's in there. And another stolen base. Griffith with some speed as well. I'm saying that he's getting the ball and they're hitting it and they're not getting to it. And that, you know, you tell your kids pitching.
Absolutely.
Let your defense help you. Don't try to strike everybody out.
Yep. Don't worry about placing it. Throw strikes. Just throw strikes. You've got 8 other guys out there.
High ball. 3-0. On deck is Robert Johnson.
Robert's having a good year. Really swinging the bat well.
Yeah, he grounded out the first at bat, but we've seen him in several games drain some pretty serious outfield balls. Pitch, outside, ball 4.
Walks him.
Now walk it out. 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 Now playing for the Devils, Robert Johnson.
9-1, Russell leads. Davis at first. Griffith at third. Here's the pitch. Swing and a miss by Robert Johnson.
Speed fooled him on that one.
Yeah, he was looking for him to throw it at him, and he didn't. Yeah. Just lifted it high and outside. Yeah. Evan has the same issues sometimes. Here's a pitch. There it is. They're going to have to hurry to get him. They're going to throw it across the infield.
I believe he's safe. Out. Oh, he's out. All right.
So, he grounds out for the second time, this time short to first, and that's the third out of the inning. In the inning, 5 runs for Russell, and it's now at the end of 2, it's Russell 9 and Greenup County 1. Back in a minute on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
Stultz Pharmacy is now offering patients compounding for their prescription needs. Stultz Pharmacy is the only pharmacy in the area PCCA certified. We can provide you with hormone replacement, neuropathy creams, scar creams, pediatric prescriptions, and we can even help you with your veterinarian needs. If you have any questions, please call 606-834-1052. That's 834-1052. Stultz Pharmacy in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy.
I go to Ashland Community and Technical College.
Because it's so close.
I go.
For the small class sizes.
I go. Because I can transfer my credits.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go to get a better job.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
We move to the top of the third inning.
Hey, he's trying to say something to
Coach. Re-enter Nickel. Thank you. Okay. Raiden Nickel in. And I didn't know he was out. Did you?
I didn't know he was out either, but we've got him back in now. Got him back in. Sounds great.
He'll be at the plate. This will be his first at bat. Speaking of Ashland Community and Technical College, join us May 7th at 7 o'clock as we present the ACTC graduation from the Paramount Arts Center. First pitch, swing and a miss by Nickel. Jenkins out in front of him just a little bit on that one. And we'll stream that live. Keith Atkins will be there. Because Donnie and I will be somewhere else.
Absolutely.
I don't know where I'll be. It's May the 7th, it's Saturday. Is that Pikeville maybe?
Seems like we are in Pikeville. Yeah, I believe that is our road trip game.
And then we'll stream the graduation ceremonies of Russell, high and inside, Raceland and Greenup County. I think Greenup County's first on the 20th, Raceland's on the 23rd, and Russell's on the 28th. All live here on GreenupBeacon.com and the OLBH Network. Swing, pops it. Ball hit the plate, it's foul.
Did you say Greenup graduates on the 20th?
Yes, they're ahead of everybody. 20th, 23rd, 28th. Now, in years past, we've always done Boyd County, but this year, in our contacts, we have not heard back, so I don't know if we're going to do that one or not. Pitch. I'll tell you a good story here, Donnie, while we watch Mr. Nickel bat. We first year, we also streamed Fairview, and about halfway through, the kids walking across the stage, this girl turned around and tears coming down her eyes. Here's a pitch. And chopped out front. And on to Tice from Jenkins, and Nickel is out 4-3. And her sister had graduated. And her sister's husband, who she married right before he shipped out, took a shift change in Iraq during the conflict and was able to see his wife graduate.
Wow. Yeah. What a great story.
Yeah. I got chill bumps from that. I mean, it's pretty good.
Makes it all worthwhile right there.
Uh-oh. This one lifted high in the left. Finally over.
Whoa, what
calls
a great
it in.
Catch.
Nice catch. So Evans flew out to second to start the game. Flies out to left. He flowed out.
He flew out.
And next we have Eli Sammons. No comments from Amy and Michael, please. Inside a ball. I also text Tom Stoltz to see if he'd be interested in watching the game. But, you know,
absolutely.
When you make the big bucks, you have to work all the time. So here's the pitch. Down to the third. Nice stop. Comes across the infield to Tice. And that's three up, three down. That was Salmon's out 5-3. And that was not field as cleanly nearly as much as I'm sure Curtis Davis would have liked to. But nonetheless, he got it and did what he needed to do. And we'll be back in a minute on the OLBH Green and Beacon Media Network.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
Super Quick owned Subways, you can buy 3 footlongs, $5 each, or a regular salad for $5, or mix and match any 3 salads or footlongs for $15.
Available only at these Super Quick Subways: Cannonsburg, Greenup, Cerrito, Ironton, Colgrove, South Point, Vanceburg, and Flatwoods.
Subway, eat fresh. Well, we're taking a broad guess.
We're going to take a guess at this, and I think it's nickel.
And we're going to go with Braden Nickel on the mound.
I bet you a dollar it's nickel.
Here's a pitch. I don't make the money you make, Donnie. So I'll just tell them it's 9-1.
Bet you a nickel it's nickel? How about that?
There is a mercy rule after 5 if it's a 10-run lead. 15 after 4, 10 after 5. But Greenup County certainly has the opportunity to bat a couple more times.
Yes,
as
they do.
Does Russell.
I've gotten to see these kids play. They're good. They're having kind of an off night tonight, looks like. Out of sync. We all have them.
And this at the plate, according to my official scorebook here. Heck, I don't know who it is.
Ethan Sharp? Is batting.
Yes.
2-2 on him.
Right. Okay. We can do that. I have been asked to tell you, Joe, that when you go left or right, go slow. Because when you go fast, it just blurs.
Okay.
We'll get you there. If we don't, then, you know, it'll come in time. It's a long time to get this down. Outside of ball. Ball 4. So that sends Ethan Sharp. He walked to first. And this is up next is Nathan Conley.
Now batting for the Devils, Nathan Conley.
Left fielder for the Devils. Sharp at first. Conley at the plate. Nickel on the mound. Pitch to Green, and sharp with the stolen base.
I believe we have in attendance the middle school principal tonight. Looks like Sean Moore is out there taking
good.
In the game. Always good to see when the administrators support their kids.
Stolen base. So Sharp's at third. Two stolen bases in this at bat. It's a 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Ball bounces up. Nice save by Green behind the plate. That puts Sharp back at first. Two balls and a strike. So with the 2-1 pitch on the way, high ball three. Sharp still at third. My guess is if it's not straight down the middle, Conley will take this one by.
Absolutely.
Nichols having a little control problem, but I've heard they're pretty good, so tonight might just have been a bone night.
Owens
flies out the shortstop, and he is doubled off.
Doubled up.
6-5 for
back up
the
to
second out, and F.
Now batting for the Devils, Austin Watkins.
6 for the first out was Conley. Made nice contact though. Austin Watkins at the plate. And the left-hander delivers, high outside of ball. Now, Sean said he could see soccer and baseball. He'll miss the band tonight. Sean Moore, principal at Russell Middle.
He's hitting all of them tonight, huh?
He too, well, he's going to miss the band, but he too is the Russell graduate. Three of the four building principals are Russell grads, as is the superintendent.
That's a long ball.
That's deep, but center fielder settles under out there. And that would be Austin Evans, and he settles under. So for the first time today, three up, three down, even though Sharp got to third, he got picked off. And Watkins flies out to center field for the third out. So it's still 9-1. We'll be back with the top of the fourth inning to look at Drew Stoltz, Griffin Keaton, and Ashton Lacey on the OLBH Green and Beacon Media Network.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
When I first come in, I go get on a rolling chair. It has little rollers and you lay down and it pushes, like, does them in your sore spots, upper and lower back. And when I get my, and there's sticky things that they put on your back. And they feel so good because you feel a little tingle and it feels good. And after your first time, it's your best friend. And with the thing I love about being at Dr. Whitaker's office when he pops me and cracks me is when after he pops me in my sore spots and it feels great.
Back at Russell High School Field, Donnie Prater along here with Hank Bond. Joe Applegate on the camera. Isaac Stevens brings it to Cameron Campbell. And the first pitch foul down the first baseline by Drew Stoltz.
Never seen Brad Stoltz move that quick. He got out of the way of that one fast, didn't he?
Well, he'll be much nicer to his son from now on. Brad Stoltz, the coach, down at third. Ball outside. Stoltz landed out third to first in the first inning. For the inning's third out for Greenup County. Pitch swung on.
Chopper.
Popped out fair.
In trouble.
I don't know if we're going to get him or not. Missed him.
It's okay.
So we're going to give him a single, I think. I don't truly think that was an error.
I wouldn't error that.
If he were a high school senior.
We got.
I don't know what we're doing.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
Griffin Keaton at the plate.
That's my favorite one.
What did
he
say?
I told him at church I was going to do him that way.
I couldn't hear it. Is he out? No.
No, he was safe.
Well, they're appealing. They got nothing out of it. So Tice will come over, try to hold Stoltz on. Base hit. I believe that's the first one of the game. It is. No, second hit in the game.
Second hit?
Green had a hit.
Ooh.
Ooh, almost got him. Isaac's got a good move, and so does Evan.
Absolutely.
That being left-handed helps Evan. That's two steps. All he has to do is step and throw.
They got him. He got him.
Yep, nice play.
Great play.
So, Isaac Jenkins picks off Stoltz. And that is the first pickoff this season by anyone other than Evan. He has had two. Did Ronan catch that?
Oh, groovy, baby.
Was it Ronan that caught that?
That was Ronan in right field.
Right,
sure was.
Okay, so Keaton, one pitch, one out, as he flies out to the right fielder, Ronan Moore. I have to tell you what Michael said in just a second here, Donnie.
Oh.
Foul ball. Got up on that one. Now, this young man, Lacey, has some strength. Michael, who is watching the video stream, when you play that and the crowd laughed,
mm-hmm.
He says, you know, it's funny when I can hear my mom bellowing a laugh. Austin Watkin settles one-handed and three up and three down. Even though Stoltz did single, he was picked off first for the first out of the inning. And we move now as they scored none. It's moving to the bottom of the fourth. It's Russell 9 and Greenup County 1. We'll be back in a minute on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network. To settle in for the bottom of the fourth inning, it'll be Cameron Campbell, Peanut, Evan Tyson, and Isaac Jenkins. First three up for the Devils. Campbell is over one. He grounded out in the first and walked in the second, but he did score And we'll move on now to give him another shot at the plate. Pitch, swung on, lifted down the first baseline. Second baseman steps over. Second baseman being for them is Griffin Keaton, and he hauls it in. And so that's the
now
first out.
For the Devils, Evan Price.
Donnie knew how to pronounce Evan's last name because there is a Tice theory.
The Tice equation. That's how we calculate how fast water moves through the ground.
Evan chased that pitch from that left-hander. Leave it open. It ain't going to hurt us, buddy. There's a strike. Here's a pitch. Swung on, lifted up, foul. They chase it over. Catcher settles under it. And so Tice fouls out to the catcher, who is Richie Green. Because I don't have numbers, I'm assuming it's the same catcher. If I mispronounce anyone from Greenup County's team, we're both sorry. Whoa, don't knock my pop over. Here's a pitch, inside a ball. Amy wants us to stream every game.
It's too much fun.
We might have a few more at home. It's hard to travel because you never know what the away teams will let you do.
Right.
There's a pitch.
Oh.
This one. Out.
Oh, boy, boy.
So Isaac Jenkins with a great fly, a lot of power, but hauled in out there by the third baseman, Ashton Lacey. So it's a 3-up, 3-down inning once again. And so at the end of 4, Russell 9 and Greenup County nothing. We'll be back in a minute here on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
Our emphasis has always been on first name friendly service with a hometown touch. We know you and you know us. Hometown people helping each other grow. We're here to serve all your banking needs. First and People's Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC. We are the home office.
Hometown people, hometown spirit.
Visit the Sungate Alpaca Company to experience the vibrant cultural heritage of South America and discover the extraordinary luxury fabric called alpaca. Wrap yourself in a stylish alpaca scarf. Transform your living room by adding texture and color with a hand-loomed alpaca throw blanket, and add a little extra warmth and cozy fashion with an alpaca.
Donnie Prater.
The crowd is going crazy. Look at this, Hank. I've never had this many people cheering for me. Oh my gosh, they're...
I wish Marcy was here.
Yeah.
But she will see this.
I got some people cooperating. Your wife is cooperating right
now. Is she? Get her down
on
here, Joe. Can you get it? Got to twist the handle.
There you go.
Here we go.
Come on, song. Hurry up.
Oh, it's... It didn't hurry up for us. All right, about ready to get back to play.
Well, it was fun while it lasted, guys.
You kill me, grew up, has one quit taking it away. I don't know what you're talking about. Send me another text, Michael, so I know what you're talking about. Here's the pitch to the plate.
Oh,
grounded, third baseman.
Down third.
Picks it up.
Fires it.
On to Tice. There's one out as Richie Green. I'm saying the name's wrong because that's not who's catching. And that's what they had on the lineup. I can't do much about that. That might be, but I don't think so. I think the catcher's 36. So whomever, I apologize.
Yeah, they're batting Colton. This is Colton here. Oh my goodness. He
Colton
unloaded on that one.
Over the head of Vernon Moore. But a good throw will make it really close. At second, here it is. He's in there.
Just in.
Clean double for Colton Holman. Well, whoever. course, you know, Donnie, Michael lets autocorrect fix his texts.
We know that gets you in trouble.
No, I don't, Michael. It's 9-1. No runs in the inning. 9-1. Gotcha. I understand.
Here's the pick, man.
Whoa! Joe Campbell will come out of there hollering now.
Yeah, he's wild over there. Well,
wanting to know if they're just... Or Donnie the other day up for everyone, if they were going to hold him on or just let him run. Pitch. Sidearm. Shortstop picks it up. Looks over to third. They've got him in Holman. There it goes. Out of the way. Going to take him all the way over. Got him.
Tagging. Good job, boys.
So... What's up now?
They're yelling batter out.
They're arguing about something.
How was the batter out? I didn't. Is it a line drive?
I don't know.
That was some confusion, but it's okay. Get out of this inning.
Well, the batter was out. We're just not sure how. As we move to the bottom of the fifth inning, it is Russell 9, Greenup County 1. How's that?
Right.
There you go. We got that. No, he's not out.
So there was only two. Okay, well, I already reset the scoreboard, so.
Only two out, so we're going to start over.
Okay.
So you'll have to see what happened. Just leave it just right where it is. He was on a fielder's choice, advanced to second. Other one in a rundown. This one, ball gets away. Campbell looks up, fires it down to third, and he's in there.
You know, if they score here, I'm going to have to reset the entire scoreboard, so I need to write some things down.
Well, I've got it if you don't.
Okay.
Donnie.
2-4-1-5-0-0-0-0.
Pitch. Strike call. Ball on a strike. Nickel at the plate.
We'll hopefully get him right here. Right at him.
Foul ball out of play. Two outs. Runner on third. Pass ball sent him down there. Pitch, swing and a miss. That's three. And now we move to the bottom of the fifth with the score Russell 9, Greenup County 1.
At Carmen Funeral Home for more than 100 years, the original mission of the firm hasn't changed. They've always intended to provide the best and most professional services complemented by the finest products. Stop in today and see Bob Green or Mark Ratliff at Carmen Funeral Home in Flatwoods. Carmen Funeral Home, people serving people since 1913, from pre-need to final arrangements. Carmen Funeral Home.
Stultz Pharmacy is now offering patients compounding for their prescription needs. Stultz Pharmacy is the only pharmacy in the area PCCA certified. We can provide you with hormone replacement, neuropathy creams, scar creams, pediatric prescriptions, and we can even help you with your veterinarian needs. If you have any questions, please call 606-834-1052. That's 834-1052. Stultz Pharmacy in Greenup, Flatwoods, and Wheelersburg. More than you expect from a pharmacy.
Stultz Pharmacy.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
Money bring the funny things.
Renner Moore will step in to lead off for Russell. They went down 1-2-3 in the last inning, three pop outs. Tice popped out to the catcher. Campbell popped out to second, and Isaac Jenkins popped out to third. Getting under this pitch, the lefty's holding that pitch up on him.
He sure is.
And then it drops.
Bang. So hard to, it's hard so hard to resist that high fastball. Yeah. You see it floating in, you think, I'm going to absolutely kill this ball.
Right.
9 times out of 10, it doesn't work out that way.
Moore in there with a 1-1 count. Get one to mound. Finds a pitch. Here's one. Foul. Got out in front of it. Donnie Moore, or Donnie Prater, Mr. Sound Effects.
They didn't see it, but
if you keep it up, you might get a real job.
Absolutely. I'm doing all these on my own with just me and a microphone.
Foul ball, third baseline. Time for runner to hit one right down the middle.
Right up
the gut. Hit it right over the center fielder's head. What do you think?
Oh, that's what I'm looking for right here. We need a home run.
We haven't had one this year, have we?
No, we have not. The only one I've seen was the boy from Johnson Central.
Oh, mercy.
Went right over that scoreboard.
That was there
the
it is.
Biggest eighth grader.
Picks it up. Moore all the way down. Got him. That's a nice play, though. I'll have to say that.
Very
assuming
nice.
That Stoltz is short and Holman at first. You say it's Holman, that is. That was a great play. Out 6-3, first out of the inning. That's four straight. Five.
Now batting for the Devils, Josh Griffith.
Griffith will step to the plate. He had to sacrifice the center field to score a run. Walker was stranded at third in the second. And here is his third attempt. Pitch, outside of ball. Donnie and I think we need to take a grill to away games so that we can tailgate.
I think we should get one of the portable ones to hang out the window here at the score box.
Well, that'd be okay.
I don't want to take any money. Well, yeah, away games, okay. I was going to say, games. I wouldn't want to take away from our own concession.
No.
Because there's some schools I wouldn't buy anything from their concession stand. But
yes, I know. I heard that. But there was no problem with that outside of ball 3-0. Marilyn and I helped keep them in business.
Yeah, I think you guys had it bought enough to cover it. I think they did all right that night. Yeah. Well, we ended up.
I saw your kid, yeah. Kid over there cheating, but that's beside the point.
Those waffles.
Swing and a miss. Three balls and a strike. I think you got a little nick on that. You're watching greenupbeacon.com, greenupbeacon2.com, and foul. You know, I noticed, Donnie, that this is slow enough that they're having trouble with it. Just like we did the other day. We
absolutely
hit the first guy who had a little bit on it, and then we started to struggle.
It's true. We do better against a fast pitcher.
Oh, well, some a of shot. Us do. That's in the center field. Oh. And under to pull it in is Austin Evans. Nice but a play. Nice lick by Josh Griffith. And that is F8 if you're scoring. Two outs. And at the plate now, Curtis Davis.
Now for the Devils.
Walk.
Curtis
one for
Davis.
One and stranded in both innings. Russell's left three on. Greenup County has left 1, 2, 3 on. This one's lifted high in the air. First baseman Holman comes over, settles under, and he pops out. Pop fly out to the first baseman in foul territory for the third out. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 consecutive Red Devils retired by the Junior Musketeers. We'll be back with the top of the sixth inning and a seven inning affair right here on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
I go to Ashland Community and Technical College
because it's so close.
I go
for the small class sizes.
I go because I can transfer my credits.
I go because
I can take classes when it works for me.
I go to get a better job.
I go for some of Kentucky's most affordable tuition.
I go because it's crazy not to.
For all the right reasons, Ashland Community and Technical College. Higher education begins here.
Betty Gallion and the Greenup County EMS want you to know the qualified staff is available to you 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. For transport, call 833-1515. And for medical emergencies, call 911. Greenup County EMS, when seconds count, accepting Medicaid, private insurance, and private pay. Greenup County EMS.
Hank Bond, along with one and only Donnie Prater to our left and Joe Applegate to our right. Fortunately, there is only one of them, each one, because I've had that said about me the better part of my life. So, you know, I just want everybody to know that we have Greenup County players coming to play. According to my official score sheet, this will be Austin Evans, the center fielder.
Austin Evans.
We do this again, Donnie. We need to get the numbers of the players.
Right. Yeah, that's the only thing that I like to have is a number.
Here's a pitch. Swing and a miss. I don't know if he nicked it or not, but yeah, he threw his hands up. Foul ball. So that's 0-1 on the center fielder who made a great catch out there on Josh Griffith's deep fly. This one down a third baseline foul. Just foul. Now, you know, in Brad's heyday, Donnie, he would have caught that ball.
Oh, absolutely. He'd have laid out and made a spectacular
one. Yeah, and then drained him at first.
Right.
But this is not his heyday. And
that's right. So our heyday is long gone.
Great guy, Brad is.
He sure is.
He's good to everybody, just like his dad and Tom. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
Pitch inside a ball. I've known Tom since high school, which was before you were quality thought. I didn't know Dave so well. I knew who he was. But then I've done business with Dave. Lifted high, foul. Coming right back here.
That hit right on top, didn't it?
It did. Broke every window in the press box. One ball, two strikes. Strike three. Nice. So Austin Evans takes the call third strike, and that's two batters in a row that have taken a call third strike as Nichols struck out to end the bottom or top of the fifth. And so with one out, here comes Eli Sammons. He was the pitcher. I don't know where he is now. Do you?
I don't know. I think he's playing. No. I don't know.
Well, as I said, if we do this again,
we will
do a better job of getting their rosters.
It's my first time on radio, so this is definitely a good learning experience.
Well, you're not on the radio. You're online. And ball. There's pictures that go with this. That's face. Why we turned the camera.
Yeah. I was going to say, with a face for radio, I shouldn't have been on the camera.
That's what Marcy told me, keep you off.
Oh, gosh, yeah.
I don't ever get on the camera except sometimes by mistake. Pitch, swing, and a miss.
Big swing.
Two balls, two strikes. Second batter of the top of the sixth. We're going to have to break down and put the lights on, Dad.
Yes, we are.
The pitch, swing, and a miss. What a nice pitch.
Okay, no hit,
strike
ball.
Three.
Sweet ball, I did it very much. Ball. That's our
break. That's three strikeouts in a row for Isaac Jenkins. And so we have Drew Stoltz come up, the third hitter. He has a single on the ground out. He was picked off at first. Jenkins to Tice. Rollins taking care of business.
Yeah, right? He and Sadie are burning up the crayons out.
That's
there.
That's it. Pitch. Grounder right back to the pitcher.
Nice.
Jenkins picks it up, tosses it to Tice. Almost waited too long, I have to say that. But that's three up and three down for the Junior Musketeers. And as we move to the bottom of the sixth inning, Michael, it's Russell 9 and Greenup County 1. Back in a minute on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
Meet the Hoopers, the all-star family. With Dad, Mom, son, Grandpa, and Baby. With a good neighbor right next door, a system that would like and so much more. It's the Hoopers.
Choosing the right college is a big decision. Ohio University Southern offers more than 30 degree and certificate programs. Whether you're in Ohio or just across the river in Kentucky or West Virginia, our tuition is a best value in the area. Attend a world-class university and stay close to home with free parking. Ohio University Southern in Ironton and Proctorville. Imagine your possibilities. Enroll today. Visit ohio.edu/southern or call 740-533-4600.
Back here at Russell High School Field for Russell Middle School and Greenup County Middle School, our middle school team. Russell 9, Greenup County 1. It'll be 8, 9, and 10 to bat for Russell.
Who's coming up? Ronan Moore coming up to bat?
Robert Russell? Johnson.
Robert Johnson.
Now batting for the Devils, Robert Johnson.
A little bit of walk-up music. I want to say hi to our buddy Donnie Jordan Ryan over in Peebles, Ohio. He watches all our webcasts. Pitch. Outside of ball. He also listens to the radio station and keeps me informed. If there's a technical glitch, then I can fix it. Swallowed another wasp, did you?
That one had bones in it.
Whoop.
Uh-oh. Crash.
Foul out of play. Somebody must have made the big catch.
Yeah, it's our softball team over there. Some of the girls from our middle school softball team just made a wonderful catch over there. Full extension, caught it before it went over the back rail of the stands.
And didn't fall over.
Absolutely not.
A ball and a strike. Down the third baseline foul. Again, the third base coach way too slow.
Yeah, he's got to make that play. He has got to make that play. He's going to coach third base.
He played third and short. You'd think he'd knock that down with no trouble.
I would think so.
One ball, two strikes on Robert Johnson. Here's a pitch. Inside corner, strike three.
Oh, I don't know about that one.
You know what? We don't get paid to call him. I got told that the other day.
Absolutely.
So here's Ethan Sharp.
Sharp up.
Oh, somebody needs a nap.
Now batting for the Devils, Ethan Sharp.
Yeah.
Now batting for the Devils, AJ.
Uh-oh.
Oops. I was putting AJ Rayburn up.
Here's a pitch. Outside of ball. Got to wait on him.
He's trying to get the stop.
Bottom of the sixth inning, one out. 9-1, Russell with the lead. Takes two to win it this inning. Pitch, ball. They're coming up here to get you. I see it happening now.
I can see it. Somebody's about to come through the door.
Well, maybe not.
They must not need money. That sounds like a Ryland and a Sadie to me. That's what that sounds like.
It might be Ryland because Sadie's down by the gate. Here's the pitch.
Okay.
Ball gets away from the catcher. Not too far.
Oh, I see Sadie.
So that makes us three balls, no strikes. Ethan Sharp, he's walked, grounded out. Got shot down at third on a double play. When Conley popped out to the shortstop, back in the fourth. Strike one, three balls and a strike. Here's the pitch. Inside a ball. ball four it is. So sharp walks, and we'll see Nathan Conley, who struck out swinging and popped out or flew out to the shortstop to set up the double play back in the fourth. So he has one on, again, Easton Sharp. That's his second walk. So he's over one on the day. And here comes Conley, who's struck out and flown out. Or popped out, depending upon how you want to say it. Throw back to first. And had it been a good throw, he'd have been out.
He had a big lead over there.
Big lead over there. Nickel, I think, is the pitcher, and he made a really nice throw. Because you don't have to telegraph what you're doing when you pitch with your left hand.
Absolutely.
You just step.
They just there got it too easy.
Whoop, went through, and that'll be a wild pitch. I have a feeling that the pitcher had that on his mind, Donnie.
Thinking too much, wasn't he?
So, a ball and no strikes. Is that two? One.
That would be...
I don't know.
I got distracted. Marcy texted me looking for the score, and I got distracted, so...
Ball. You know, you could tell her to look on her smartphone and go on a website. She could watch
streaming live.
That's why we're streaming it live. So just now that I've totally ridiculed her, make sure she watches the replay.
Absolutely. People like her, we're doing this for them. It's a service.
Pitch. Swing under his strike two. He throws a lot of that off-speed stuff like Evan does.
He does.
I do believe it's two and two, but I'm not, until he holds his hands up, I'm not going to.
Well, he holds them up, but he holds them up in front of his chest guard.
I can't see him.
Not much to our benefit. Not much to anybody's benefit, really.
No, pitcher. Swing past the pitcher, goes
no matter,
to short.
Oh, what a nice play.
Stoltz across the
coming
infield.
Across the infield. That
nice play for the second out. So Conley out, Stoltz to the first baseman over there, Holman, and that's the second out. Sends Sharp on to third, and Austin Watkins, who has flown out deep to center, walked and singled, scored two runs. Now we did have an inside the park home run. I think he did. At Fairview, popped it up, tossed the bat. Out to second. Second baseman is Keaton. He hauled it in. So Russell goes down with one runner left. Watkins pops out for the third out. Move to the top of the seventh with the score Russell 9 and Greenup County 1. We'll be back in a minute on the OLBH Greenup Beacon Media Network.
Around the corner or around the world with the Greenup Beacon.
And we're back for the top of the seventh inning. And it'll be Keaton, Lacey, and Green. If my memory serves me right, Mr. Prater, this should be the last inning.
Absolutely should. See what happens right here.
You never know about these things. Mr. Walk-Up Music himself. 9-1, Russell leads. Jenkins still on the mound. Here's the pitch. Call strike one right at the bottom of the strike zone. And Griffin Keaton is at the plate. We thank you for joining us here. Swing and a miss, strike two. On greenupbeacon.com and greenupbeacon2.com. Game will be archived at greenupbeacon.com and live and streaming archives. Selection of a few hundred there.
Uh-oh, could be Steven, trouble.
Steven, or Wildcats on, got
what
him.
What a play.
High State on the base.
Heads up
and they got
right
him.
There.
Nice play from Austin Watkins to Evan Tice. Tice held that foot over there, and he'll now get two desserts. And it'll be with one out, Ashton Lacey. The good thing is he won't know all this that I've said until he watches the replay. And with that said, we'll already be home and I'll be asleep. And here's second. Picks it up on to first. So Tice gets the assist on another one. Lacey out second to first. As was handled nicely out there by Ethan Sharp. And the hacker to my left is going to play one more walk-up.
Yeah, I'm really struggling tonight. These allergies are killing me. I mute my mic.
I see Tom Stoltz was on the plane, and I'll share the link with him tonight. No surprise there. One ball and a strike. And the pitch. Outside. I don't know what that was, but it's a good thing Ethan Sharp's out there. We'll be waiting a half hour. Peanut about threw that one to the wall. Two balls and a strike. Jenkins. Kind of stretching his arm out a little bit.
Mm-hmm. He's pitched
Could
a
be
real...
tired. He's done a nice job today.
He has pitched
this one. Grounded to Sharp. One knees it, picks it up, on to Tice. Game over. Russell wins it. And so it was a great inning. Russell gave up exactly one run. And that run was a single, two singles. In the second inning that allowed that to happen. And so we have come to the end of this one. The final score was Russell 9 and Greenup County 1. I'll be honest with you, I know we have several streaming events next week. I just can't remember where all they're going to be. But we will be back on the air if you check our website at greenupbeacon.com. We will post a schedule coming on there. I thank you for joining us with Donnie Prater, Mr. Hazmat himself, cameraman Joe Applegate, who has earned his stripes today after he slowed down a little bit. He got great compliments from the West. And the B game, or the second string, or Team B, or whatever you call it, coming up here at Russell High School Field. Plenty of time to come out if you have time. Please come out and enjoy a game. For Donnie and Joe, this is Hank Bond. Again, the final score, Russell 9. They got 9 runs in the first 2 innings, did not score after that, and Greenup County got its 1 in the second. Thanks for joining us here at greenupbeacon.com and the Our Lady of Bellefonte Hospital, Greenup Beacon Media Network.